When an element has two or more forms that contain the same number of protons but different numbers of neutrons, we refer to them as isotopes. Let me explain this with a James Bond analogy. Imagine working as a secret agent for your country. To keep your identity safe, you have been assigned a code name, let's say 008. Your best friend and colleague is also a secret agent with the code name 007. You know him as Bond, James Bond. Although you both have different code names and personalities, you share one thing in common. You are members of the same secret agency, just as isotopes belong to the same element family. Isotopes are different forms of an element with the same number of protons, but different numbers of neutrons. This means that isotopes belonging to the same family of element have different properties. The periodic table arranges elements according to their atomic number, the number of protons an element has. Hydrogen, the element with the lowest atomic number, has the first position, followed by increasingly heavier elements like helium, lithium, beryllium, and so on. The mass number of an element is determined by how many neutrons it has, while the atomic number is determined by its number of protons. If you add or remove neutrons from an atom's nucleus while keeping the number of electrons the same, you will essentially create an isotope of that element. An atom's chemical and physical properties are determined by the number of protons and neutrons in its nucleus. When you create an isotope by adding or removing neutrons, it will have different properties than the parent nucleus. Isotopes are formed in two primary ways. Firstly, they form when an unstable atomic nucleus undergoes radioactive decay by emitting radiation in the form of alpha particles, beta particles, photons, and neutrons. This process can occur naturally, as many naturally occurring elements have unstable nuclei. The other method by which isotopes form is human-driven. When a stable nucleus of an element is bombarded with charged particles, like protons and electrons in a particle accelerator, it can create isotopes of the same element. In some instances, the same process can turn that element into another element entirely. This process is known as transmutation. Every element in the periodic table has isotopes. For example, hydrogen, the first element, has three naturally occurring isotopes: protium, deuterium, and tritium. All three isotopes have just one proton, but different numbers of neutrons, 0, 1, and 2, respectively. Carbon, one of the most fundamental elements for all of life on Earth, also has three isotopes. The first isotope, carbon-12, has 6 protons and 6 neutrons. Almost 99% of carbon on our planet is carbon-12. The next heaviest carbon isotope is carbon-13, which contains 6 protons and 7 neutrons. The third and the rarest of the three carbon isotopes is carbon-14, which has 6 protons and 8 neutrons. It's so rare on Earth that only 1 out of 1 trillion carbon atoms is a carbon-14 isotope. Carbon-14 is radioactive, which means that it decays into stable atoms. This property makes carbon-14 the perfect candidate for estimating the age of organic materials dating back as far as 60,000 years through a process called carbon dating. Yeah. All organic materials on Earth contain a trace amount of carbon-14. As carbon-14 decays over time, it causes the quantity of carbon-14 in the material to decrease. To better understand this, think of an hourglass where the sand gradually decreases as time passes. Scientists can determine how long ago the material was alive by measuring the amount of carbon-14 remaining in the material. This technique is useful when studying the environment, living organisms, and ancient artifacts that archaeologists uncover during their excavations. Isotopes are prevalent and affect all of us in some way. They are used in medical research, diagnostic imaging, and the treatment of various diseases. In many shapes and forms, isotopes improve productivity, enhance health and safety, and obtain information that is otherwise challenging to acquire. For example, selenium-75 is used in gamma radiography to enable non-destructive examination of thinner-walled steel surfaces. Americium-241 is applied in certain smoke detectors. Oceanographic researchers use silicon-32 to better understand and model the global climate. Isotopes also have many uses in security and national defense, safeguarding a country's borders against various threats. For instance, nickel-63 helps airport security officials detect explosives, hazardous chemicals, and vapors. Neutron detectors also aid in identifying the illegal transport of nuclear materials at airports, border crossings, and ports. Additionally, isotopes like uranium-234 and lithium-7 are essential for the smooth functioning of nuclear reactors. Learning about isotopes is like discovering that even elements have family trees, with some members choosing to hang out with extra neutrons, while others stay lighter. In a time where we rely so much on understanding the world around us, the diverse world of isotopes stands as a testament to the beauty of scientific discovery and the endless possibilities it unveils.